Hi, I want to talk to you about a very recent study published in 2009. This was a study looking at vitamin E supplementation in patients that have Alzheimer's disease. And the title of the paper was Vitamin E Use is Associated with Improved Survival in Alzheimer's Disease in an Alzheimer's Disease Cohort. The study was published by Pavlik and fellow researchers in the journal known as Dementia and Geriatric Cognitive Disorders in 2009. This was the study design. It was fascinating, really. They took 847 patients that had Alzheimer's disease, and they gave some of them a vitamin E supplement, 1,000 IUs twice a day, 2,000 international units, a fairly high dose. They gave another group just a standard Alzheimer's medication. And then they took a third group and gave them the vitamin E supplementation with the Alzheimer's medication. So it's brilliant. And then they gave the other group the placebo. They gave them really no therapy at all. And they waited a very significant period of time. And these were the results. That the Alzheimer's patients who were given the vitamin E supplementation actually showed a 23% improved overall result in terms of decreased mortality over the study period. 23% reduction in mortality compared to the group receiving no therapy. Here's what's sort of a bit fascinating. The group that only got the medication actually showed increased mortality, just slightly increased over the group that got no therapy. So it's interesting. I don't know if that's, going to be standard across the board for all Alzheimer's patients, but it showed up in this study. But here's the kicker. That the group that got the vitamin E supplementation with the standard Alzheimer's medications had the very best overall result. They had a 30% reduction in total mortality from all causes, and they had more stable disease, improved function overall. So when you combine vitamin E with the standard medication for Alzheimer's disease, you got the very best result in these patients. So vitamin E can be helpful in Alzheimer's patients. The truth is, the sooner they get access to it, the better. That's what studies have been showing. 1,000 international units twice a day seems to be the logical dose. I say that because there was a previous study called the Alzheimer's Cooperative Study that did exactly the same thing. They gave Alzheimer's patients 2,000 international units a day of vitamin E, and they showed a slowing of the progression of their disease and overall improvement in symptomatology generally. But this study in 2009 was the very first time we saw that you could combine vitamin E supplementation with a standard drug for Alzheimer's disease. The two of them can be taken together. Here's the other thing to note. There's been some reports in the media recently, researchers looking at what they call meta-analysis studies, blending studies together, suggesting that high doses of things like vitamin E can actually increase your risk of cancer, heart disease, scaring people away from vitamin E and vitamin C supplementation. In this study, giving these older people with Alzheimer's disease, who are already prone to premature death at this point, high doses of vitamin E, it's actually extending their life. They weren't developing cancer or heart disease. So I happen to think that that's just a little bit of manipulation by a certain entities out there that have their own agenda. The truth is that very few antioxidants like vitamin E can actually cross from the blood into the brain. And so what happens over our lifetime is that the brain is using 20% of all the oxygen in your body. And when it does that, it generates some byproducts of metabolism called free radicals. And these free radicals, as you know, can be quite dangerous, cause a corrosive effect on the brain that we think may actually increase the risk for Alzheimer's disease and maybe some other neurodegenerative conditions. In fact, Dr. Russell Reiter tells us that, as we get older, our melatonin levels drop off as we get older. And melatonin is one of the real key brain antioxidants to protect the brain against free radical damage. But as we get older, we make less of it. Dr. Russell Reiter at the University of Texas, who's a neuroendocrinologist who's done a lot of the studies on melatonin, suggests that maybe taking some melatonin supplementation may also be useful to prevent some problems in the brain as we get older. But that's a topic for another day. What we're seeing here in the vitamin E study is that studies are now showing that we consistently see improved outcomes in people with Alzheimer's disease in terms of their disease state and overall survival statistics. What I'd like to provide to you today, if I can, is sort of an overall prevention scheme. What do you want to do as you get older? If you don't have Alzheimer's disease now, and there's a good chance you don't have it, How do you preserve your memory as you get older? As the body's genetic time bombs go off and free radicals affect your brain, how do you protect your memory as you get older using diet, lifestyle, and targeted supplements? So you're going to see some copy in the script below that's going to give you some of those highlight points that you can read after the video is over to give you sort of the diet, lifestyle, and targeted supplementation strategy to protect your brain against the effects of aging that I believe are really important. So thank you for watching.